Okay, so I realized something. I am definitely not as good at shredding the dirt as I thought I was. What's up, floaty friends? Steve Ginter here, and as you can see, I'm not in my garage. I'm still on the road and just got back from a super exhausting but very exciting Shredfest 2. And wow, I was overwhelmed by all the fun activities and stuff going on that I kind of screwed the pooch on getting good footage. But that's okay, because I'm just gonna try and do my best and share with you the footage that I did get so that you can kind of experience it if you didn't get to go, or if you were there, maybe I got some shots yet. So let's go. First off, getting there was quite long and boring, mainly because I drove there all by myself and it was just a long drive from Phoenix. Now, I thought about bringing Mikey with me, but yeah, that guy can get kind of annoying sometimes. So, admittedly, I was pretty excited when I finally did get there.
We're almost freaking there. Almost there.
And even though I was running a little bit late, thankfully my one-wheel Arizona family was already there and saved me a tent spot right next to the dusty road that they kept watering down to tame all the dust. Anyways, there was just so much stuff going on. They had custom-built wood tracks, a cool little terrain park, an amazing stage set up for music. There were vendors and club tents lined up along the road, and well, there were just one wheels floating around everywhere. On top of all that, there's all of these activities. And I haven't even mentioned the races yet. Wow, some of you guys are just amazing on the trails. I mean, I decided I'd try my hand at racing in the amateur men's. So I rode the truck up to the top of the mountain, which is where it starts, went downhill to do my time trials, and yeah, I placed 32nd. In my defense, I was a complete noob and didn't discharge my battery before going downhill on a race, which basically meant around halfway down the mountain, my phone and my watch were vibrating nonstop with this familiar alarm. Yeah, I'm an idiot. I'm just glad my board didn't shut down on me while I was going down, nor did I eat it on my downhill ride, so that's a win for me. Some of the real winners were actually one-wheel Arizona racers that I know. I think Brandon, he placed first in the Clydesdale division, which is the heavyweight or 200-plus pounders. So that's freaking awesome. Congrats, dude. And Zachary Zinn, who's someone I ride with frequently out in Phoenix, out on the trails out there, he won in the over-the-hill division, which is the 50-plus.
And then in first place, hailing from Arizona, Mr. Zach Zinn. Congratulations, legends.
Yeah, that guy could probably be racing in the pros because he, like I said, he easily got first place. He even posed for a photo at the finish line when he messed up his jump. That's how far ahead he was. So while I didn't get to partake in any of the races after the time trials, since I didn't qualify, I did get to spectate and watch all the really good racers. And while I was doing that, of course, you know me, I love to take photos, so I had my camera in hand and just took a ton of photos. Here are some that I took during the time trial races. Here are some of those EUC guys. Yes, EUC guys were there this time, and they were awesome. Here are some during semifinals on the teeter tots. And here are a few slow motion clips of the last ramp at the finish line during the finals. If you were there competing in the races, chances are, in that fast montage of photos, I probably got a shot of you, and before you even ask, yes, you can have a copy of the photo. I'll leave a link down in the description to a Google Photos album so that you can go look for yourself, see if you're there, or if any of your friends are there, download it, put it on your social, whatever you want. I just love taking photos. Love it if you wanted to share it with the rest of the world, so go check them out. P.S. If you don't follow my One Wheel Instagram account, you should go check it out. I might not be the best rider out there, but I do my best to try to make it look as cool as I can. Alrighty, on to the rest of the festival. What other footage do I have? Oh yeah, the night scene. The night scene was just wow. The camp was surrounded by awesome lights. Full senders would be actually full sending it off ramps. I mean, look at these guys. Freaking just, I mean, that's the definition of full send, if there ever is one. Hype trains were going around spreading, quote, joy, unquote. Late night rides would spontaneously fly by in the trees. You just see a line of lights. People gathered around big fires and stayed warm while listening to music. Heck, speaking of fires, there were even fire dancers performing. Two nights, for hours. And the music. So many good bands performing and keeping the vibe going all night. And I do mean all night. Because after a day of riding, you do get kind of tired and you want to sleep. Telling you, AirPod Pros sound canceling, that was a good investment. Speaking of music, the founder of One Wheel Arizona, the group that I'm a member of, he actually performed his own original hip-hop rap songs after the award ceremony and just absolutely killed it. Whenever my trend to hit the pavement, they say the range isn't the greatest. Thank God I weigh less. And whenever I'm floating, I feel weightless. My fate is for momentum. I'm on the case quick. Good vibes in the air, I can taste it. Like floating midfly, I just want to ride. Let me show you what fun feels like. Now throw your hands up if you came and found that shred that you're seeking after. Now throw your hands up, now throw your hands up, now throw your hands up, cause you have to. This is a cover, yeah, we get down, yeah, yeah, we get down. This is a cover, throw your hands up, throw your hands up. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. There was One Wheel Brawls where they would have everyone get on their boards, anyone who wanted to participate at least, and just brawl it out and see who was the last man or woman standing. And whoever was, got a prize. That was really fun to watch. This is a melee. If you're down, take your board and go. Josh, you're up. All right, let's start. Tighten up the circle. Tighten the circle. I just want to say thank you to everybody who helped set up the event, organized it, coordinated, choreographed, the vendors, the musicians, the entertainers. I mean, all of it came together and I just had an absolute blast. And if you ever get a chance to go, I highly recommend it. It's on my way up there in the to-do list, especially if you're a one-wheeler, being able to just zip around camp, meet other one-wheel friends, ride on some trails, and just have a good time. And thanks to everybody who came up and said hi to me. It was so nice to see some of you guys and meet you in real life and just seeing who's on the other side of the screen that watches my vids. One more thing, I did bring my GT with me. I rode the crap out of it. I used it up and down the mountain multiple times. It is filthy as heck and it still works. So good news if you are a GT owner or are planning on getting a GT, this one's holding up for me at least. Okay, well, I've got a ton more footage that I couldn't figure out how to squeeze into this dialogue. So after I shut up here, I'm just gonna roll some of it to some music so that you can enjoy it and see what it was like to be at TreadFest 2022. All right, enjoy.
All right, One Wheel AZ out here at Seeking Shred, having a grand old time. Got the fam up in here. Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo! Yeah!
Alexander, and today's episode is brought to you by the Trails of Gnar. We're only the gnarliest shred, so let's grab our wheel and roll out.
One Wheel AZ got more layers than lasagna. Do a real happy crew still waving as we passing you into the future motion with devotion to a single wheel. Balance is the key, stay afloat like a king. You'll feel unimaginable that this thing is real. Keep it even keel, break the seal on excited feels. It's like, yeah, it's electric. The feeling that you're getting was crushing a flowy segment. They always ask me which direction am I headed. My head looks and then go, go, my gadget gets it. No need for details and such, just respect the beast and it's likely not to fuck you up. O-W-A-Z much more than an old up club, spread stoke like legs giving up the one love, or the more the merrier. This one wheel may be the death of me, but if so, I hope that is death's barrier to carry me across the plane of hate to get to my fate. On the way, break free, pick the locks on heaven's gate. Now I'm chilling at the top with my past kin. First question, did you make that, is what they asking. I had to break the F out, it's not my time to go. Plus you know what I'm about, hitting heavenly trails with a fam, the Flow Mob crew, keeping the stoke high. You know how we do. On my one wheel, what one wheel? On my one wheel, what one wheel? On my one wheel, what one wheel? Though you may see me rolling, I'll be feeling like I'm floating. On my one wheel, what one wheel? On my one wheel, what one wheel? On my one wheel, what one wheel? Though you may think I'm floating, I'll definitely be stoking whenever my treader hits the pavement. They say the range isn't the greatest. Thank God I weigh less. And whenever I'm floating, I feel weightless. My fate is poor momentum. I'm on the case quick. Good vibes in the air. I could taste it in a different world, like the planet did a shapeshift. Seeing scenery that would make the average ape shit. Pouring some out for the homies that have ate shit. Nose dives, no joke. Roll properly and still hope for no bones broke. Collarbones pop, unlike the way the players do. Over the edge, riders go. The luck and fate of you. Actually, everyone I'm known to touch a one wheel, just a rite of passage that we go through. No big deal, get back on it right into the sunset. The fun gets better as you become one with unified. Tell everyone you should try, it's a real life changer, regardless of the danger. And I'm no stranger to a full send. I'm not Nike, but just do it. They lose it when my mind controls the cardio movements on my one wheel. What one wheel on my one wheel? What one wheel on my one wheel? What one wheel? You may see me rolling, I'll be feeling like I'm floating on my one wheel. What one wheel on my one wheel? What one wheel on my one wheel? What one wheel? Though you may think I'm floating, I'll definitely be stoking. Yeah, I'm Aaron Alexander, and though I wish I was there with you, I'd like to send a shout out to all the one wheel riders.
What's up, what's
first,
up?
First, lots of love goes out to Seek and Shred for throwing Shred Fest.
Thank you.
Huge shout to DJ Steel for blessing us with his outdoor set.
Much
some
love.
Other shreddy heads to thank include Jen, Carissa, Mercedes. Okay. Manuel, yes. Austin, and Neil, mad respect.
Some
sponsors that help make this happen include Jeff and the Float Life fam, Chai Battery, Function Gear,
yes.
Four Season Shred,
you,
Bob's man. Stoke Shop, Flux Movement.
How's it going? Steve Ginter here. And it is the last night of Seek and Shred 2, 2022. It's past midnight. And I'm at the top of the mountain, just checking my phone. And I'm thinking, you know, I might go down this mountain. So, anyways, it's been a blast. Catch you guys in the next one. Later.
Oh, this is exciting for you. This is sure as hell exciting for me. I'm stuck in the... Stuck in a rut, like I was saying.